guys! In case you don't know me, my name is Witchy Cupcake and welcome to the Cupcake Coven! On our last Discord Explained video, we talked about Discord etiquette for server community members. But today we're going to talk about Discord etiquette for server owners. Now, a Discord server is like social media for a creator on steroids because it is a platform where people can be talking to you 24/7 and sharing all sorts of content. So it's very important that you have the know-how of how to manage your community in the best way possible. So today I'm going to share with you some of the best practices that I have found when it comes to Discord etiquette. The first thing that you should be doing as a Discord server owner when you start a Discord community is to learn the basics. Discord can seem a little bit confusing at first, but it is very important that you understand and learn how the settings for the server work, how your own settings on your profile work, how the community roles function, because if you don't know this, then you won't know how to manage the community in the first place. Thanks to the internet nowadays, you can find tutorials about basically anything online. So just search for that information out there and I'm pretty sure you'll be able to find it because I found it myself. You should also be mindful of having a system in place so you can filter community members, because there are trolls out there that are simply dedicated to joining Discord communities to, you know, spread hate and just cause chaos. So make sure you have measures in place so you don't let just any person in. I myself go through a very thorough vetting process with who I let into my Discord server. Probably if you're a larger creator, I mean, you'll have it open to everyone, but in that case, you'll most likely have enough moderators to help you out with the tasks of banning people if they start posting weird stuff or just like being hateful. But if you're a smaller creator and you don't have many people that could help you out with moderation, I think it's best to make sure that you don't just have your server open to anyone and everyone, because people could come in while you're asleep and destroy your server. So make sure to put in some measures to avoid that. Another basic thing that you can do to have a well-functioning server is to create chat rooms for different subjects. And the reason for this is because usually if you have only one chat room, depending on the size of your server, it can go, like, text can go by too fast and people can get lost in the subjects. So it's better to have different rooms for different subjects. Also, if you're playing like a specific game, for example, and only certain community members are interested in knowing about that game, you can have that reserved to a specific chat room. You know, there could always be the possibility that other members don't want to know about that game because they're waiting to play it themselves and they don't want to hear any spoilers. So it's kind of good to have the rooms divided up like that. When it comes to the basics, you will probably have to adjust accordingly as time goes by, as the needs of your server might change with time. You might want to add rooms, change the permissions of different roles, and so on and so forth. Another essential factor to Discord etiquette is to be active in your server. You would be surprised as to how many times I have seen creators open up a server, you know, put it together all really nicely, and then they just don't talk in there. So, like, I would definitely recommend starting conversations with your community members. And if you don't really know how to do this, I can tell you a really quick and efficient tip, something that I do myself. I just say, happy whatever day of the week. Example,
happy Friday.
And then from there, people might respond. And, you know, they're not always going to respond, but that's a way that you can get people to possibly talk. Another way is to just say,
how's everyone's day doing today?
Basic things like that can really encourage people to speak up and start conversations, because what's the point of having a Discord server if you're not going to talk on there? In addition, make sure to make new server members feel welcome. You know, greet them, ask them how their day is going, maybe tell them what you guys were talking about, because as a new member of a server, it can be quite intimidating at times because there's already people there who have created usually a friendship, and you come right in into a long thread of conversations and you have no idea what is going on. So try to include the new members by just being nice to them and reaching out to them. Another way to be active in your server is by sharing fun things with people. So for example, you saw, I don't know, a cute cat picture, you can share it. You saw a nice motivational video, you can share it. Something happened in your life that you would like to share, share it. You know, obviously keeping in mind that it is still the internet, you don't want to share any like personal information or anything that could put you in danger like that, but overall, it is a place to have fun, so go ahead and share fun things with the other people in the community. As a server owner, I would also recommend that you conduct icebreaker activities. For example, you can ask everyone to answer a specific question or to share a specific kind of picture or GIF or emoji, you know, just anything that's simple that can encourage people to talk and come out of their shells and just interact with each other. If you just never talk to people, then people probably won't talk to you. So as a server owner, you are in a leadership position, and I would recommend just putting yourself out there and starting conversations and interactions with your community members. It's also important to keep people up to date with your announcements as a creator. So for example, if you're a Twitch streamer that has a Discord server, let them know when you're going live. You can set up a bot to announce when you're live. You could also let them know if you're late to something, you know, if you're running behind on schedule, if you're canceling a stream, so on and so forth. So just keep them informed about what's going on with you, creator-wise. Another fundamental thing that I would say is key to Discord etiquette is to show appreciation to your community members. You can do this by simply responding to messages. I've seen it many times that someone comes into a server and says something and it is just dead silent. So you as the owner have the responsibility to go there and answer that person. And it's understandable, maybe you're busy that day, maybe you didn't see it until the next day, that's fine. You don't need to do anything immediately, but make sure to just not leave the person ever with an answer. So if they share something, go ahead and look at it and tell them your opinion about it. Also, don't forget to thank your members when appropriate. So if anyone ever does a favor to you, let's say you went live and you forgot to announce that you were live, and a community member stepped up and did that for you, make sure to thank them for that. They didn't have to do that. They went out of their way to show you support. So make sure to let them know that you noticed the effort that they made. Another good way to show your appreciation for the community is to remember important details that community members share. So for example, if someone mentions that they have an interview coming up, maybe next week, follow up and say,
hey, how'd that interview go?
Or if someone said they had an important test, ask them how that went. Maybe someone mentioned they were taking a trip to somewhere, and just make sure to let them know that you are paying attention to them because you do care about them. I mean, that's the whole point of having a Discord server, and if you didn't care about them, then maybe you shouldn't have a server. So make sure to follow up on important things like that. And of course, you're not a robot. You can't remember every single thing that people say, but you can always go back and search for things in chat with the little search tool at the top right corner of the server. So you can refer back to conversations that you've previously had if you think that's important, but definitely pay attention to what your members are sharing. One thing that I love to do as a server owner is to congratulate my members on their birthday. Now, I have actually gotten the help of a birthday bot for this, but you can also just do it yourself by writing down their birthday. You can say,
hey, this is the birthday chat room. Everyone write down your birthday.
And then, you know, you yourself can input that birthday maybe on your phone calendar or something like that. And then when the occasion comes, make sure to congratulate people. You can do this in various ways, whether it's just giving them a congratulations message or by doing something a little bit more personalized. Another way to show appreciation for your community is to listen to their suggestions and be open to their feedback, because even though you're not obligated to do what they say, I definitely think it's really good to keep an open mind, because they might have some really helpful tips that they can give to you. And so definitely make sure to keep an open mind and listen to what your community has to say. As a server owner, it's really important to set boundaries for your community. I would say you can do this by making sure you explain the rules in a clear manner, but make sure they're not overly too restrictive, because there comes a point where there are just so many rules that everyone is just afraid to post. So find a good balance in what you think, you know, would be healthy guidelines for the community without going too overboard. Another way to set boundaries with your community is to not allow yourself to be bullied by trolls, because yes, they will infiltrate your community, and sometimes they'll pose as regular community members, but you can tell that they're a troll because they'll keep trying to cause problems, they'll be rude to other people, they'll say something bad, then they'll apologize, then they'll be rude again. They'll cause tension in the community. Maybe other people won't feel comfortable to speak up when that person shows up. So just keep an eye out and make sure to not be bullied by those people. If someone is making yourself or your community members uncomfortable, just go ahead and ban them. It's really not worth it to keep them in the community, and they will just cause a toxic environment, and no one likes that. They'll ruin everything that you have worked really hard to achieve. I personally think it's really good not to add on to any drama that may be happening. However, do take action if there is drama happening. So, for example, if people are saying inappropriate things or discriminating against other people, make sure that you don't add on to, like, fight if there's something going on, but just again, set your clear rules and boundaries and enforce them. Do not leave it up to your other community members to have to defend themselves, because they shouldn't be doing that. The server is somewhere that they should be having fun and not like fighting other people. So again, it is your responsibility as the leader to take care of that situation. Now, there are problems that, you know, regular people, like probably you and I, are not equipped to deal with. For example, if someone is talking about very serious mental health issues. So in that case, just make sure to tell them that you're a friendly shoulder to lean on, but that you cannot address that kind of thing, and instead redirect them to helpful resources that might help them with their issues that they're facing. Finally, it is okay to ask for help if you need it. So if you find that you are too overwhelmed trying to take care of the server, add some trusted friends to be moderators, and they can help you out deal with this kind of situation, especially if your community has grown quite a bit. You can also learn how to use various bots, because there are bots out there that will help you not only with moderation, but also with other things. For example, to have fun activities, like there's music bots up there, there's birthday bots to remind you of people's birthdays, and so on and so forth. So look into the possibilities of adding these automated tools to help you with your server. Don't forget to watch tutorials out there regarding anything that you think you might need to learn about Discord servers, because, you know, there is a lot of help on the internet, as I mentioned before. But if you don't find the necessary information that you're looking for in a tutorial, don't hesitate to reach out to other creators. Usually people are pretty open to helping fellow creators out, so just ask for help and you might find the answers that you're looking for. And of course, don't hesitate to ask for your own community to help you out, again, with tasks that won't burden them. But for example, they could remind you of birthdays, or you could put one person in charge of this thing, one person in charge of the other. That way they will feel more involved with your community while also lending a helping hand to you. Alright guys, that is it for today. I hope you enjoyed the tips that I shared regarding Discord etiquette for server owners. If you did, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. It really helps out the channel. I would also like to invite you to subscribe if you would like to see more content like this in the future. And if you have your own tips that you would like to share with everyone, don't forget to leave them in the comments down below. I'm really curious to see what you guys have to say. If you would like to hang out with me live on Twitch, you can check out my streams there by going to twitch.tv/witchy_cupcake. I stream a variety of content over there. We have a lot of fun, so join in if you want to. And of course, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your week, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!